We have to understand it's a long basketball game. And, Golden State's not going to win it in the first minute. We're not going to win it in the first minute, vice versa. So we just have to make sure we stick to the game plan. We play as hard as we can for as close to 48 minutes as possible and see what happens.
Tony Harvey, NBC Sports Radio. Coach Brown, step back about 12 months, since you've been hired, and you pretty much, planted in the community. Just to editorialize it, there's about 2.5-3 million people live in this region, about 60 to 70 different languages, and just want to get your thoughts, about living here and feeling this fever, breaking that curse, anything that you can provide.
No, it's been fantastic, and I said this before, I had a couple of buddies that lived up here when I was living in the Bay. Roe and I had friends that lived up here in Sacramento, and this is before we even got the job, and they talk about how special this place is, how fun it is, and all that other stuff. And after getting a job and moving up here, even before the season started, we thoroughly enjoyed the Sacramento area. It's underrated, and we enjoyed it a ton. And obviously, going through the season, having the year that we've had, and feeling the excitement, because you already knew the fans were passionate from back in the Arco days. You knew they knew the game of basketball. They had a great feel for the game of basketball from back in the day. But to actually go through a season where we've had some success and be able to experience, their joy with them has been an unbelievable feeling for not only myself but my family too. And it's much appreciated that we're able to be a part of this.
Ron Krajcik, San Francisco Chronicle. Hi, Mike. Curious, as you prepared for this, how do you prepare for a guy like Andrew Wiggins as you're doing the scouting? And for a guy who hasn't played in 2 months, do you prepare any differently? Do you expect him to be rusty, or do you expect him to be Andrew Wiggins that we all know? How does that sort of affect your mindset and preparation going in?
It doesn't. I mean, you're talking about a team that has basically their whole team has championship experience, and so they know what it's like to go through anything and everything adversely at the highest level. Yes, he was out, but we're not going to expect him to be rusty. We're not going to expect anything less than what he's been bringing to the table when he's played this year, which is shooting the ball unbelievably well. We know how he helped us when I was with the Warriors last year. He helped us win a championship with his ability to offensive rebound and his ability to defend a lot of different players night in and night out. So, we expect him to come ready to play.
Anthony Slater with The Athletic. How up-tempo do you expect this series to be? And I know obviously you want your offense to go up-tempo, but how concerned are you about, it getting real, I guess, wild out there with them?
I give my man Ant Slater a shout out. He had a little son the other day, little AJ. So let's give it up, AJ, little AJ. My girl Carmen, I hope you're feeling good at home. But I had to give you a little shout out. What was your question, Slater? What was your question? We want to play fast. We don't know any other way. Obviously they like to play fast too, but they've been in all types of games, and so they can adjust a lot of different ways. But we feel our best chance is just to be who we are, and that's playing extremely fast. So we're gonna try to put our foot on the gas pedal and go, and hopefully it's faster in the playoffs than during the regular season. And that's yet to be seen, a team playing fast in the playoffs, because it just naturally seems to slow down because it's a more physical game. But we're going to try to let it loose.
Mike, Jason Anderson, Sacramento Bee. Earlier in the week, you guys had a team dinner. You mentioned that HB and Deli and Leandro addressed the team. I'm curious what the last 24 hours have been like. Have you been together as a team? Did you have dinner? Did anyone else, you or others, address the team about opening this series?
No, I mean, I had my car washed today. Buddy of mine came in from Cleveland, and we chopped it up a little bit. We watched some of the games. You know, we practiced yesterday, but I just had dinner at the house. Nothing really special, you know. But you know, those guys were really good addressing the team because they all, you know, obviously LB played too, so he has it from a player's perspective, and then he also coached, and so he has it from a coaching perspective. So to be able to get that from him, to be able to get it from Deli, who obviously played with a completely different team and faced these guys back in the day, and then to get it from HB was a, you know, a great diverse group to hear from going into the playoffs. And for our team, any little bit helps, you know.
Mike, Chris Biederman, Sacramento Bee. Just with the way series goes and the adjustments that can happen as the series progresses, given your familiarity with Steve and the coaching staff and the personnel, do you think you sort of have a head start on what those adjustments might look like as the series progresses, or does your familiarity help from that standpoint?
I don't think so. I mean, these guys know me too. I've been around them for 6 years, and so they know me just as well as I know them. And at the end of the day, you know, really, in all the years I've been in the playoffs, every single time we faced somebody, no matter what team I was with, they knew us inside and out, and vice versa. So, you know, I know that's been the talk because I was with them for 6 years. I know these guys, and I know all the tricks. I wish I did. You know, these guys are good, and we're game planning and preparing like any other team that we would face, and we have to execute on both ends of the floor for as close to 48 minutes, and if we do, then we'll have a chance to win. If we don't, it's going to be tough, you know, because they're a good team. You know, you got to give them that they're the champs, and we got to go take it from them if we expect to move on.
Hey, Mike, Tim Roy, Warriors Radio. How you doing?
What's up, buddy?
I wanted to know, you've had a lot of playoff experience. So where do you think you have grown from your first playoff experience as a coach to right now?
It's a great question. You know, one of the things that I've taken a lot of stuff from everybody, from Bernie Bickerstaff to Tim Gergovich to Pop to Rick Carlisle, Steve Kerr, on and on in my journey during basketball. And, you know, one of the things that I learned from Pop that I don't know if I was really good at back in the day is, you know, during the season, that's when you really, you know, kick your teams behind if you're going to do it that way. And in the postseason, you got to kind of flip the switch. You know, you've kind of learned everything that you should have learned during the regular season, and now you got to encourage them and love them and all that other stuff because, you know, you want to make sure that they believe, and not just for one game, but for the entire run, however long that run is. And part of that is making sure that you're not too tight. You know, you got to have appropriate fear, but you don't want to be too tight because you don't want them to feel that at all. And so I going into this series, I feel pretty relaxed. I'm pretty conscious of what, you know, I feel like I need to do to help these guys, and we'll see if it can unfold that way.
Hey, Mike, Chris Tavares, Channel 40. Do you have a win one for the Gipper speech? Anything planned? What's your final message going to be to the team before they go out on the court?
You know, I'm going to reiterate the same stuff that we've talked about. You know, I just want them to understand how important that is. And the reality of it is, you know, if you throw everything out the window but two things, we have to play with the physicality on both ends of the floor, especially defensively. We got to hit first, second, and third. And then we have to play with pace, you know, not just in the full court but in the half court too. And we got to try to do those two things for as close to 48 minutes as possible. And if we do, we're going to give ourselves a chance.